Hello, good morning class 8 students. We are meeting again with our chapter 6 combustion flame. In the previous classes we read about these following concepts like what is combustion. Let us begin with what is combustion. So we can define combustion as burning of a substance in air or oxygen with simultaneous evolution of heat and light, followed by ignition temperature of a combustible substance. So there are many combustible substances you have seen. Now what is ignition temperature? Ignition temperature is that lowest temperature of a combustible substance at which the substance catches fire. So in the previous classes we have learned that the ignition temperature should be overcome, then only a combustible substance will catch fire. And also we know what is a flame, which region is called flame. Flame is the shining zone in which combustible gases, combustible material burns. Okay. So in today's class, we are going to learn about structure of a flame. It was your last week's homework. First of all, let us learn what is the structure in a candle flame. In the previous classes, we have learned about luminous and non-luminous flames. So now we know that a luminous flame is the yellow colored flame, while a non-luminous flame is the blue colored flame. A luminous flame, that is the luminous zone, produces more heat and light, whereas a non-luminous zone produces very less heat and light. So the structure of candle flame, first of all let us know what is the structure of the candle or what is the material it is made up of. Candles are made from paraffin wax. Paraffin wax is obtained from the residue which is left during the fractional distillation of crude oil or petroleum oil. In the previous class, I guess you have read about fractional distillation of petroleum or crude oil. So when the crude oil is passed through the distillation column in the process of fractional distillation, there are many materials which are separated out, like diesel, kerosene, petroleum jelly, as well as paraffin wax. Therefore, this paraffin wax is a petroleum product. It is a mixture of higher hydrocarbons. Paraffin wax is a mixture of higher hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons are the compounds made up of carbon and hydrogen. These are known as organic chemicals, which have specialized structure and distinct order. So paraffin wax is a mixture of higher hydrocarbons and contains very high percentage of carbon in it. Therefore it can be used as a fuel. Also paraffin wax vaporizes on heating. Let us continue. A candle is a column of wax having an unspun cotton thread, which is called the wick. The unspun cotton thread, which passes through its center all along its height, and this is called wick. Let us see the structure. This is the wick in the candle. So when a candle is lighted, the wax starts melting. It is because the wick, the temperature of the wick increases. Because of high temperature of the wick, automatically the wax starts melting. This molten wax rises up through the wick due to the capillary action of the liquid and gets vaporized. Capillary action is seen in case of liquids, due to which you can find that in case of water, droplets of water are present on the surface of a say tube or water pipe, and the liquids tends to move in a flow due to its capillary action. So the molten wax rises up through the wick due to capillary action, and then it gets vaporized. The vapor of wax then burns in the air to produce a luminous flame. Now, what is a luminous flame? Please try to answer. What is a luminous flame? A luminous flame is the yellow colored flame which produces appreciable amount of heat and light. So a luminous flame is obtained when a fuel undergoes partial or incomplete combustion. A candle flame, here you can see alongside, you can see the structure of a candle flame. Therefore, we can say that there is incomplete combustion in case of candle, because the flame is yellow in color and luminous. Now, according to the scientist J.J. Vergilius or Johannes Jacob Vergilius, a candle flame consists of following four zones. Now, let us see what are the four different zones in the candle flame. The outermost zone is faintly blue in color. This is called outermost non-luminous zone, which is faintly blue in color surrounding the yellow part. It is blue in color because here there is complete combustion of the fuel, wax vapor. There is complete combustion of the wax vapor due to presence of sufficient oxygen. It is the hottest part in the flame. Next is the middle part or the central luminous zone, which is yellow in color. This zone is moderately hot and there is incomplete combustion of the wax vapor. Due to incomplete combustion of wax vapor, it produces carbon particles which get heated up. The carbon particles get heated up and starts glowing. Therefore, this zone produces the most light and yellowish in color, and it is moderately hot. But this is the major part in a flame, the central luminous zone. This is the major part in the candle flame. Next, it is the inner dark zone of no combustion. The dark zone is around the wick, where there is very least or no combustion takes place, because this zone does not get supply of air. Therefore, there is presence of unburnt carbon particles around the wick. This zone is the zone of least heat. The last and the lowest zone is again the lowest blue zone in a candle flame. It is blue in color because of the complete combustion of the carbon monoxide produced during incomplete combustion. You have read previously that carbon monoxide is the gas which is produced due to incomplete combustion of the fuel. So here in this lowest blue zone, there is complete combustion of those carbon monoxide which is produced due to incomplete combustion in the inner dark zone. So these are the four different zones in a candle flame, four distinct zones we can see. That is outermost non-luminous zone, which is blue in color of complete combustion, central luminous zone, which is yellow in color of incomplete combustion, inner dark zone of no combustion, dark area, and the lowest blue zone due to combustion of carbon, burning of carbon monoxide. So here you can see the different parts in a structure of a candle flame. That's it. In the diagram, you can see the prominent parts, like number one, outermost non-luminous zone of complete combustion, which is blue in color, and it is the hottest part. Number two, the central luminous zone of incomplete combustion, which is yellow in color, moderately hot, and it is the most bright zone in the flame, yellow in color. The third part is the inner dark zone, which is least hot in the structure. And the last and the lowest part is the lowest blue zone. So you please draw in such a way, color the different parts in proper colors. And here also you can see the melting of the wax. So students, we are now done with the structure in a candle flame. And I guess the concept of being luminous and non-luminous are clear to you. Therefore, there is one more example in your text that daily life experience, that is, why does kerosene burn with a blue flame in a wick stove? Kerosene used in this wick stove, you might have not seen this type of, because these are very least used at our domestic purposes, but it is a very useful material. Okay, so in this kind of wick stove, we can see the fuel, that is kerosene, burn with blue flame. Why? In the kerosene lamp, you must have seen such type of lamp. The cover is of glass. In kerosene lamp, it produces yellow luminous flame. So it is very much clear from this structure, I guess, that kerosene, when burnt in a kerosene lamp, it burns in a limited supply of air inside. Therefore, the carbon particles undergo the kerosene undergo incomplete combustion, and the carbon particles glow, which produces light. But in case of this stove, the fuel burns in presence of sufficient air. Therefore, the flame is blue in color. Now we'll read about this wick stove, where there is a perforated sheet surrounding the wick. Through these perforations or holes, here perforations means holes, through these holes, air enters the stove and helps in complete combustion of the fuel, that is kerosene vapor. This is the reason that in a wick stove, kerosene burns with a blue non-luminous flame. Here you can see there is the perforated sheet with holes. So I guess this example is clear to you. So after completing the part, just go through and try to answer these questions. Like, which gas formed during complete combustion of fossil fuels is responsible for global warming? Yes, you're right. The answer is carbon dioxide. Next, a deadly poisonous gas which is formed during incomplete combustion of coal, which is carbon monoxide. Okay, so students, please go through these questions and try to answer these. We'll again meet in the next class.